This is an excerpt from my free online mini course, The 7 Steps for Making It as a Mural Artist. If you want to view all 7 steps in the one place, then sign up for the course for free via this link. Hi guys, my name's Fieldy. I'm a professional street artist and muralist, and I'd like to welcome you to my new online mini course, The 7 Essential Steps to Making It in Mural Art. So these are my top 7 things that you need to know when you're starting out working with clients to paint murals for money. So if you want to know more, or you want to explore any of these topics more in depth, then come check out my online art academy, link up the top there. My first essential step is conducting a site visit and meeting with your client. A site visit is a meeting with your client at their proposed wall. It's where you're going to get a close look at the wall, see where it's situated, and to be able to find out what your client is after. A site visit and meeting with your client is a great first step, as it allows you to troubleshoot any potential problems with the location or the wall, and to find out from the horse's mouth just what your client wants from you. It's also a good opportunity to measure the wall and take some photos of it for your concept and figure out if you need to hire any further equipment such as scaffolding, a scissor lift, and you can also examine the wall and see what preparation work it needs. Ultimately, meeting your client and seeing the site for yourself is going to save you time, headaches, and money later down the track. When you get to the location, measure the height and width of the wall and take note of any impediments such as windows, doors, power boxes and cables. Take a photo of the wall from as front on as you possibly can with minimal distortion. You could just use your phone or you could use a camera, but you'll be using this photo to create your concept or scribble grid if you need to. That happens later on. Examine the wall carefully and take note of any damage. So you're going to be looking for dents, peeling paint, cracks or mold. Take note of the finish on the wall. Is it bare brick or concrete, or has it been painted before? If so, what kind of paint was used? Oil-based or water-based paint? If the surface is super glossy, find out whether it's been anti-graffiti coated. How tall is the wall? Will you need a scaffold or a cherry picker or a scissor lift? If you think you may need to hire something like that, check for overhead power lines and see if the ground is level and if there is a clear access way to the wall. How far back can you get from the wall? When it comes time to get your concept up on the wall, is there enough room to project it with a projector, or will you need to use a grid? Is there access to power, water, and a bathroom? Are there specific hours you can access the site? I.e., if it's in a busy cafe, you might only be able to access it after the cafe is closed. Is the area safe? If it's a building or construction site, you're going to need to think about working around heavy machinery or other potential dangers. Asking these questions is going to help you write an appropriate quote and help limit any unpleasant surprises when it comes time to paint the wall. When you're talking to your client, you want to find out as much as you can about their expectations, budget, and ideas. Questions you should consider asking include, do you have an idea of what you'd like painted on the wall? Have you seen my work and are you familiar with my style? When do you need it painted? Do you need me to use any particular colors or include a logo? Do you have a budget in mind for the project? So this is to determine if they're in your ballpark. Some clients won't want to answer this question, but it's helpful to see what their expectations are in this regard. If they're expecting it to cost way less than you charge, then you have the opportunity to just cut your losses and not waste any further time. But if they're expecting to pay way more than you would normally charge, well, you know, then you know you've got some room to add more value to the project. Do you have permission for this wall to be painted? Is the client the owner of the wall, or do they need to get the permission from the wall's owner? This is normally if they're a business and they're renting the premises. We're going to be using all the info you've gathered from the site visit to write up a professional quote for your client. If you want to know more or explore this topic in depth, then join up to Fieldy's Art Academy All Access membership for only $49 a month and get access to all of my courses, plus monthly group coaching sessions with me, where you can ask questions, update your progress, and even receive art critiques in a supportive, friendly environment. This is a massive saving, and it's really going to help you turbocharge your art career and help set it up right. I'll be adding new videos on a regular basis, so there will always be something new for you to learn on your art journey.